Apple has introduced a new feature called Containerization. I know, very clever name. An open source Swift package for macOS that enables running Linux containers in lightweight virtual machines or VMs, similar to how Microsoft has the Windows Subsystem for Linux or WSL. So Apple introduced the containerization feature at WWDC 2025. And it's designed to leverage Apple's silicon virtualization capabilities, optimizing performance for the M-series chips. So it runs a Linux kernel inside of a small VM, and it's basically built for macOS's new version of macOS 26 Tahoe. For those who are familiar, they were on macOS 15 and have switched to 26. And the reason is because it's like the year, but it feels like they're doing the car style of doing the year, the next year in the current year, which either way, whatever, that's why it went from 15 to 26. So let's look at the details with this particular news. And we're on the announcement page from Apple, and you see this paragraph. That's it. That's all the information they gave us on their news announcement page about the Linux containers. So we're going to have to go to a different source, and that is OMG Ubuntu. So OMG Ubuntu reports that Apple's container tool follows the OCI spec, which is very good. This uses OCI compliant container images, so you can pull and run images from any standard container registry. You can push images that you build to those registries as well and run the images in any other OCI compliant tool. Using open standards is important because it means that it should work well with existing container ecosystems like Podman and Docker and Kubernetes. So that is fantastic. But of course, Apple has decided to think different with their approach. Apple's approach runs each container in its own lightweight micro VM rather than having a multi-shared kernel approach. So it's complete with an isolated Linux kernel and a network stack in each of these micro VMs. Instead of using the shared kernel or a shared virtual machine like other systems do, Apple is doing an isolation for each container, which may offer some stronger security benefits, but could also be a downside for some with less shared states between workloads. And whether it can compete with Podman or Docker, well, that's something we'll have to wait and see. I think it's an interesting thing that they're doing. I think it's a really big news. So this could be some benefits to the Linux ecosystem. I think there is a lot of potential for it, much more so than in the Windows side of things, because the way they're doing it is a little bit better. And it took a long time for Microsoft to figure out that they needed a kernel involved. So it does seem like Apple learned from Microsoft's mistakes in that sense. But overall, I think there's some potential here. Let me know what you think in the comments below.